Hey, I just wanted to share a story. I was at game four with my parents. Obviously, it was a tremendous game. But, you know, my mom's been battling multiple myeloma for the last 5 years, which, as you know, is the form of cancer that I believe Don Baylor just passed from.
Right.
And not only, you know, obviously that was sad, but it was encouraging to see that he lived with it for 14 years. You know, she's on five now, and she's, like I said, she's had her ups and downs. All she's been telling me was her bucket list was to go to Yankee Stadium, see Aaron Judge hit a home run. So I told her, if they advance, we'll get tickets. Well, of course they advance. She told me to pull out all the stops, get the best seats we can. So we're in 128, field MVP. You know, Yanks are losing 4-0. I'm just starting to get a little sour. They're going to lose this game. She's telling me, they're coming back. They're coming back. And when I tell you he hit that home run and she just broke down sobbing, and it put everything into perspective, and it was just such an amazing moment. And, you know, I don't know if this message somehow gets to Judge. I'm not looking to meet him, anything like that. But not only was that a huge home run for New York, huge home run for the Yankees, but it's just something that my family's going to treasure for the rest of my life. And it was, and then to go on and win the game was just icing on the cake. I mean, we're dancing to Sinatra in front of our seats, and it was just tremendous. I can't speak enough of just what a great moment that was to be able to share with my mom.
Well, first of all, we wish her the best, obviously, and hope that she's, you know, does well, and, you know, we send her our prayers. And sports can do that. I mean, you know, baseball is a great companion for people, and they get very attached. You hear that a lot of times with people later in their lives or people who may be housebound, how baseball especially, because it's there every day, it's like a companion. Because, you know, it's 5 hours. If you take the pregame, the postgame, the game, and it's every day, it's like a book, you turn the page. If you start in March with these guys and you go through spring training, you know, and you go through the spring training games and you go through April and then May when it starts to get a little warm and then June and then the heat of July and August and then into September when the leaves start to turn and then into October if you're lucky. Here you are in late October. They're still playing baseball games. They've now played into the 175 area of baseball games on the season. It's a lot of dates, and it's a lot of dates on the calendar, and it's a lot of time for people to get very attached to. So I think baseball, more than any other sport, really is able to do that for people. And I've known that through the years from people who get very attached to the teams, you know, whether they've been ill or they've been they're older, and they get very attached day-to-day to the teams, which I think it's a very nice thing, and it gives them a very something to really have some fun in, something they can emote with, something they can really cheer for, and, you know, it's there on a daily basis. So from that standpoint, it does provide something very important. And again, we send our best to your mom. Back after this.